want to spend a couple minutes now on a story about something that I guess still carries a lot of stigma. It's a problem that men have called gynecomastia, and it's the issue with overdeveloped breasts in men. And a lot of them who have this, it affects them for their entire lives. And the solution, there's a pretty quick fix. It's a male breast reduction surgery. More and more men are looking into this, having it done. So, of course, we wanted to talk to the expert, Dr. Stephen Mulholland, founder of Spa Medica, one of Canada's top cosmetic plastic surgeons. Dr. Mulholland, welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me, Barb.
Is this something that you are seeing an increase in men inquiring about this or having this type of surgery done?
I think that it's been very common for a long time, and we've got the baby boomers getting a little older in their 50s and 60s now. And so male gynecomastia, or the 50-year-old male boobie, is very common. The problem was, in the past, no one wanted a scar around the areola. With the new energy devices like BodyTite and Smart Lipo and Phaser, plastic surgeons can make tiny little incisions, liquefy the gland and any fatty tissue, and really flatten out the chest without the scars that typically would have been associated with this procedure in the past, and made men a little bit self-conscious. But now, quite a simple procedure to do under local anesthesia.
What is it like, and I guess, if you've heard from patients, what is it like for men to go through life with this problem and not have it dealt with?
Well, there's two segments that we see as plastic surgeons. The first market segment is the young fella who has a little bit of glandular breast bud development in his 13th, 14th year. Very, very embarrassing. You can imagine it's tough enough to be a teenager without having the dreaded man boobs. And then, of course, you're embarrassed to go to the pool. You're embarrassed in the summer to take your shirt off. You can't wear a tight shirt. It really affects you at many, many, many levels. And, of course, you know how ruthless young kids can be with their classmates. And so it really does make young men very, very self-conscious. And they can live their whole life like that, because in the past, if it was glandular, it was very, very firm, you'd have to have breast reduction scars, which are deforming as well. And again, this young group has been helped enormously by the new energy devices, little probes we can stick into the gland, liquefy the glandular tissue almost like it was fatty, and then aspirate it without having to make big cuts. So a scarless way to reduce male gynecomastia for the younger set has been huge for them. It really has. It's been a life-changing surgery.
Is there ever a case where a young boy / young man will have this issue? Are any people ever outgrow them?
Yeah, so sometimes you get a little breast bud development, like the areola is a little more prominent, 12, 13, 14, and then there's a sudden growth spurt, the chest stretches out, you develop pectoralis major, your pec muscles, and it all goes away. But unfortunately, for a significant number of young males, there's that genetic risk. It's not related to a lack of hormones. You can have normal testosterone levels. You have a normal erectile function. It's just that you have that little bit of breast glandular tissue that you got from grandma or great grandma, and it's a curse, because it doesn't matter how much you work out or exercise, you have that little breast bud. And then there's the older fella, 50, 55, 60. He was a bodybuilder. He was a hockey player. He was a football player. And he was muscular. Puts on little weight, and you get some fatty deposition on top of the pec major that's now saggy. And then you've got the 50-year-old male boobie, which is generally fatty. The problem has been, if we didn't cut away skin and you just did lipo, it would sag. Now with the modern technologies, when we heat the fat and the gland, or just the fat, the skin tightens. And again, we can avoid big scars. And that's the secret. Get a flat chest without the telltale signs of breast reduction surgery, which be unacceptable unto themselves. So now we have a scarless way for older men and younger men to have that lean, flat chest, the Ryan Gosling chest, basically.
Ah, yes. How long does the procedure take, and how invasive is it?
I mean, it takes about an hour to an hour and 20 minutes. It's done under local anesthesia, where we, a couple of a couple of happy pills under your tongue and some freezing in the chest tissue, much like you're getting your wisdom teeth removed. It's very similar to that. Now, some men are very, very nervous, much more nervous than female clients, and they might even want a little IV sedation, like if you're having a colonoscopy. But you do not have to be right asleep. You don't need a general anesthetic. Once the local anesthetic is infiltrated into the chest tissue, you feel nothing. And then there's about 10 minutes per side of heating to liquefy the fat of the gland. And then that will allow the skin to tighten. And then we remove the liquefied tissue to complete the procedure.
What's the recovery like?
There's a bit of a recovery. You have to wear a special sort of, it's a garment that looks like a tank top that has some compressive component to it. And we put a little bit of foam over the chest. And you need to wear that for about 3 weeks. So it's not the type of thing you do in the middle of August. Mm-hmm. But you do it in the winter and you're ready for the spring and the summer and ready to go south and ready to go shirtless in the summer. So give yourself about 6 weeks to recover and don't do it in the middle of summer.
What's the typical cost of this procedure?
It depends who's doing it, but the devices themselves are quite expensive. So it's going to cost a man $6,000-$8,000. But most guys would say it's money well spent.
Somebody texted in, this is actually a really good question. Why does OHIP pay for women to have breast reduction surgery, but not for men? And they're saying especially young men are often mm-hmm. severely psychologically affected by this condition.
Well, first, OHIP doesn't pay for all breast reductions. It has to be a very large reduction over a certain amount of grams of resected tissue. Otherwise, it is cosmetic. With young boys, if they're 13, 14, 15, they have a hormonal imbalance. You do some blood tests and the hormones are imbalanced. Then yes, OHIP will cover it.
Oh.
But if there is no hormonal imbalance and it is a hereditary trait like love handles or like a double chin, then the managed care system will not pay for it.
You know, in this story that we saw today about this, I was really surprised to see something. I had never heard this before, and I wanted to get your opinion on it. This story claims that the most common reason for gynecomastia among 18 to 35-year-olds is frequent use of marijuana.
Well, there is a known link between the cannabinoids, the chemicals inside marijuana, and stimulation of glandular tissue in males, for sure. And decreased testosterone levels. So we're talking a large consumption, however. For the odd weekend marijuana user or come July casual recreational use, we're not going to be spouting breasts all over Canada. It has to be heavy, heavy marijuana use.
Okay, yeah. Like we're talking, yeah, serious smokers. It's just something that I thought was really unusual. I hadn't heard that, and I don't know if people know that.
Well, you do need to be very cautious as a young man or a woman with a lot of marijuana at a young age. It has been shown to affect cognitive skills, and that's one of the concerns as we legalize that young kids are going to have access to it, and it's really going to affect their cognitive capacity and development, let alone, you know, gynecomastia. We'll have a bunch of, you know, underperforming academic guys with boobs. And so we really got to be very careful how we roll out the legalization of marijuana, at least of which is breast tissue.
You know, look, we're laughing, but there are so many guys out there who have this issue and it can be crippling. So what has some of the feedback been like from the people that have had this procedure done with you? How has it changed their life?
Oh, it's really life-changing. You know, come back, big smiles, they'll come back for their 6 or 8 week visit with a tight T-shirt on and say, doctor, you know, I haven't been able to wear this really since I was 9 years old. And so it really is life-changing. Imagine never being able to take your shirt off when you go south or at the beach or in the summer.
Or being intimate with somebody.
Right, yeah, intimate. Well, I mean, candlelights and dimmers are not just for women. Men with gynecomastia. All guys look good with gynecomastia when they're lying down. Now to stand up and actually be, you know, feeling very, very sexy and attractive. So it really does change things because to have that feminine stigma of breasts, it's just, you know, it's just not cool. It's sort of like a woman with hirsutism that has a goatee and a beard. It's just, you know, culturally not cool.
Sure. Dr. Stephen Mulholland, as always, thank you very much for this.
Thank you very much, Barb.
All right, we'll talk to you soon. Dr. Stephen Mulholland, founder of Spa Medica, one of Canada's top cosmetic surgeons.